in Glasgow. Do you want to explain where we are and why we're here?
呢度叫山仔，以前中國人咧嚟到蘇格蘭咧喺度上面住嘅，全部都係，好似好多中國鋪喺度，中國鋪啊同埋非法鋪啊，下面有好多中國人買機票。
哦，係咩？以前啲人唔識買機票，人哋喺
No, outside 有 small shop 喺度。I
think I remember that. 依家冇啦，依家。Yeah, I think I remember that though, because it used to be. I remember. Lung Fung had one too, and you would walk into the centre and there would just be a travel agent sitting there. You would go in and book your travel and then leave again.
Yeah.
I forgot about that, that was strange.
Okay, yeah, yeah, so
yeah. So where did you live?
Here.
This house here? How many people lived together?
三个.
And you didn't need to pay rent or anything, did you?
No, my boss paid it, man.
Like, this was so good to make. What were you making a week? So £500 a week. You don't pay rent. You don't pay food. Where's my job? Sounds really good. That's £2,000 a month. 20-odd years ago. That's a lot of money. If you're going out, you want to go shopping or anything like that, everything's just here, and it's all full of Chinese people. So it must have been so nice to have a community already built.
Yeah.
Wait, did Archie stay here too?
Yeah.
No way.
Archie stayed there. Every night just go disco, you know. don't need to worry about food, don't need to worry about better food, so yeah.
You just had free money to spend.
Yeah, yeah.
What's that
job?
Yeah, we'll go and have a look. I never walk this part of Glasgow. So when I come in, I usually just either drive in or get the train into the centre.
That's crazy.
啲衫喺攞度洗啊嘛，所以30幾年都喺度。It does look like
佢30幾年都好舊啊，好似啊，好舊。It's
quite crazy. Like, I think as you grow up, you obviously know your parents were young at one time, and you obviously know that what you're going through, your parents have been through. But it's crazy to actually see where it happened and what they've done, and it makes you just think like how fast your life goes by. You know, you worked here for £500 a week. And then when they had me and got married and things like that, they opened his own restaurant, so his life would have changed dramatically. He went from living in the city to doing whatever he likes anytime, no bills to pay, nothing to lose, just having fun with his friends and my Uncle Archie. And then they moved to the countryside where there's nothing there, and everyone got 2,000 or 3,000 people living bigger, and you would have lost that Chinese support. It's quite a strange thing to think about. But then he just opened more restaurants and brought his family over, so he's got his child support back. But it must have been quite a nice, almost like a teenager going to university and having like a halls, only got to make money at the same time. So now we're going to yumcha at Chinatown, which is where Daddy Hoi Chi Jo Ye. Hong Kong to London, and Glasgow could have Hoi Sun Chinatown, so he could go to Sun Jia. Yeah, then we're going to explore some Glasgow, show you some bits and bobs. There's a really exciting comparison I want to do. So there's an underground in Glasgow. I usually get the train through, but it'd be quite cool to see the difference in the underground compared to the underground in Hong Kong, because in Hong Kong, the undergrounds are every 1 to 2 minutes. It is jam-packed full, there's no seats. I mean, I've not been on the underground, so I don't actually know.
You'd be surprised.
Yeah, I think it'll be busy.
You see.
So what was it like in London? I don't know, like, when I'm in Hong Kong, I miss Scottish food, of course. But, like, most of the things I can make at home, so, like, any food that I eat here, I can make at home, it's just really expensive, but I can make it. But Chinese food, I can't really make that much at home. It's just so good. It's really good. natural rice. You just miss rice so much, like, if I had to choose between any pub and I could never eat rice from again, rice would win every day, wouldn't it? It's literally the best rice.
Don't worry, like, it wasn't fun.
But you can do anything with rice. You can make risotto, you can make fried rice, you can make... Oh, it's just the best. Holds it. Thank you. So, the subway station in Scotland, isn't that big, is it?
Is it really big?
Is it very big?
Yeah.
It's not. On all the outskirts we use trains, but in the centre there is a subway loop. It's not like Hong Kong, everywhere's subway and there's only one train. But in Scotland there's everywhere's train and there's only one subway. Let's go and see what it's like. Wow. So only 4 stops is £10.
So was this before the photo? Yes, so the first time there wasn't so many people. Like the model was very small, then it was added.
But actually, it doesn't
need to add, because now it's
6:00.
No
one can change. This Hong Kong, this would just be like one carriage size.
Do you know what the photo is?
A normal forte, is it?
No. Yeah,
Tanzig?
Yeah.
Are you being serious?
Yeah.
What's a big orange tree?
It's like the caterpillar.
Ah. It'd be so funny if it comes and it's not orange, by the way. Dad thinks that's sweet. I think that's sweet. Scan my phone and that's me away. Don't really ever buy a ticket. Today we're at a little pancake place, they make souffle pancakes. So I'm going to show you guys how it's all made and let's go backstage and see. So I ordered a strawberry and banana souffle. I love strawberry bananas, I think they're the best fruit. Oh, apart from mango ones. It's like, because it's fresh fruit, it's so sweet and it's just natural flavours and it's just...
In one bowl, they take the egg whites and mix it with sugar until it becomes a thick consistency, nice and airy, and this makes the pancake rise. In a separate bowl, they add egg yolk, milk, and mix it all together until it's the right consistency, and that is how these pancakes are made. Thank you.
lads. It's very light. They're so nice. The sweetness comes together. Because the pancakes don't have that much taste. It's a pancake. But once you add the flavour and the bit, it brings everything out. It's such a great combination. I feel like it's going to fall when I do this. Wow.
In your volcano.
That was amazing. That was so satisfying to watch it fall down. Wow.
You gotta say molasses in there.
Make sure it's real. Okay, I was wrong. I was completely wrong. This one is amazing. I'm not a big fan of this one. I wouldn't normally eat the biscuit. It's a little bit too cinnamony for me. But that cream is fantastic. That's a really, really, really nice cream. It's like you're mixing two cultures together. You have a Japanese pancake. And in Hong Kong, most of these pancakes have got like fresh fruit and things like that on them. They're fabulous. They're great pancakes, they really are. But then you bring it to Scotland and you add like a sweet side to it, because most people love sweet stuff here. So you're adding like your Black Forest on it, you're adding Biscoff, and it's just two combinations that are just amazing. It's so good. I really, really enjoyed them. I'm so happy we came here. I was a bit full earlier on, I thought, pancakes, a wee bit too full for that. But after trying them, I just feel amazing. Last bite, and then I think I need to go and do some walking to burn this whole bag off.
How many
are you? I've been here so many times in my life. Not once did I know this was a subway station. I used to come here shopping all the time. Up the back here, there's a different building. At the front is the concert hall. And behind is Buchanan Galleries. So it's just a huge shopping plaza. There's two main ones in the city centre, so there's that, then there's the Serena Centre, but in between the street down and between in the street surrounding it, it's just all shops, it's basically a shopping place. By the way, mine are still here. Well, it's still here. So right now I'm going to show you a statue of my cousin. This is Buchanan Galleries. It's I think it's the largest bus terminal in Glasgow. All the buses come from all over to this terminal. From up north to down south, they all come to this terminal. And my cousin has a statue. I don't know how it happened, but basically an artist was doing a sculpture and this is her. She was in Canada now. Kids, adults, elderly, anyone who just come and play and enjoy the music, it's free, it doesn't cost anything. You can't afford to have a piano at home, come here and play all day if you want. Up behind us, there's actually a hotel up here, so it's good for travellers who are coming in on trains, and if they get in late at night, they can just literally walk off their train, walk up there and book into the hotel. I think we've stayed there before, it's quite nice. It's very traditional inside, it's quite old, isn't it?
I
mean, you fuck with your last part. Oh, yeah, it's quite nice. I love it. It's actually full. Dad, I took the train home. See you next time. So, this statue behind me is the Duke of Wellington. And I've never ever seen the statue without the cone on the head. So people have tried to remove it before, and someone else just climbed right back up, puts a cone back on it. So it's always had a cone, and apparently it's been happening since the 80s or before the 80s, but that's the record of time we've got, so 40 something years at least. That's crazy. My mum probably hasn't seen it with that cone in its head. I don't know if they're recycled or not, but hopefully it is. So this was our quick trip to Glasgow for the day. It wasn't actually that quick, so this was our trip to Glasgow for the day, and we'll sum up there. See you guys next time. Bye.
Bye.
We'll hope you enjoyed it.